Madam Speaker, I thank you. I rise to request a statement on behalf of Senator Michael Mbito. Madam Speaker, from the onset, this statement is dated the 27th of February 2021, and it's similar to a statement that I had requested. It's on an issue of general topical concerns regarding addressing corruption in the police recruitment. Madam Speaker, I rise pursuant to Standing Order 47-1 to make a statement on an issue of general topical concerns, namely addressing corruption and in police recruitment. Madam Speaker, reports of widespread corruption in the ongoing hiring of police officers are annoying indeed. Some of the qualified candidates claim they had been locked out of the FIMC ground because they could not raise the huge bribes demanded by recruiting officers. In some cases, Madam Speaker, results of the recruitments were shrouded in secrecy. The recent recruitment of the Kenya Defense Forces officers can also not be said to have been above board. In both cases, Madam Speaker, families were asked to pay as much as Kenya shillings, 500,000 in bribes, for their kin to join the armed forces, with Kenya shillings, 400,000, being the standard figure, which is unbecoming. Madam Speaker, one discerns two significant developments in the hiring. First, the country boasts of an army of young and educated people who are desperately looking for jobs. An opportunity to serve in the security services will not only have been bestowed the youth with the patriotic duty to defend and protect their motherland, but also kicked off a journey that would lead to fulfillment of career dreams. Madam Speaker, secondly, the entrenched culture of corruption stubbornly continues to characterize recruitment in the security services. This cruelty disadvantages candidates from poor backgrounds who can't raise the bribes, dashing hopes, and opening the door for disillusionment. Madam Speaker, there's something terribly wrong with a system that rationalizes and rewards corruption at the expense of merit and transparency. It also raises questions on the commitment of agencies such as the Ethics and Anti-Corruption Commission, Independent Police Oversight Authority, and the Director of Criminal Investigation that are mandated to tame misconduct in disciplined forces. Therefore, Madam Speaker, serious measures should be put in place to ensure that there is sobriety in the security services sector. Madam Speaker, the idea that corruption has been rendered the only window to serve in the police and military should be a moment to reflect for any right-thinking citizen. It will be remembered that the government in 2005 cancelled a police recruitment drive due to bizarre corruptions. The Anti-Corruption Commission warned that 80% of the candidates had either paid bribes or used high-level connections to get jobs. A total of 60 senior officers were suspended following the debacle. Madam Speaker, the reality that the practice continues with the amount of bribes demanded increasing means that perpetrators have devised more ingenious ways to beat the dragnet. It is doubtful that Kenyans can expect individuals recruited through corruption to uphold ethics and integrity in their future careers. It is akin to polluting a stream at the source. Therefore, Madam Speaker, the relevant agencies should take action to ensure that we root out corruption completely in order to have a level ground field for every Kenyan to participate in the recruitment exercise. Madam Speaker, on behalf of Senator Michael Mbito, I thank you, and I hope that action will be taken on this matter.